Today we are going to see the programs using function call by value. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to write a C program using function call by value. Before seeing the videos, students must watch the following videos on the functions. So here I will specify the links of every video. Now today in this session we will see a program to find the sum of the series 1 factorial divided by 1 plus 2 factorial divided by 2 plus 3 factorial divided by 3 plus 4 factorial divided by 4 plus 5 factorial divided by 5 using the function. First of all, we see the concept. So here the series is 1 factorial divided by 1 plus 2 factorial divided by 2 plus 3 factorial divided by 3 plus 4 factorial divided by 4 plus 5 factorial divided by 5. So this is our series. So we know that 1 factorial is 1. So 1 divided by 1, it gives the answer 1. Plus 2 factorial is nothing but 2. 2 divided by 2 is nothing but 1. Plus 3 factorial is 6. 6 divided by 3, it gives the answer 2. Plus 2. Plus 4 factorial is nothing but 24. 24 divided by 4 is nothing but 6. Plus 5 factorial is nothing but 120. 120 divided by 5 is nothing but 24. So after this, we add this all these numbers. So here the sum of the series is 34. So we see this program on the code block. First, we create the new project. File, new project. Here we give click on the console application, then click on the C language, then give the name to the project. Then click on the next button and then click on the finish. Okay, you can see that in the left hand side it creates the project and the name of this project is sum of series. Here the main.c file is created. Here first of all we write the function declaration. So where we declare one function factorial for calculating the factorial. So here the return type of this factorial function is integer. The name of the function is fact and it takes one parameter of type integer. So here I will specify int and end with the semicolon. This is our function declaration. Here in the main function we declare the variable. So here we declare one variable sum for storing the sum. So here first of all we call the function sum equal to, because here the function fact is written in the value, so that's why the value is stored in the variable sum. So here we call the function fact of 1. So we calculate the factorial of 1. It is divided by the 1 plus here we know that in the given problem statement we require the sum. So that's why here we add the plus symbol. Similarly, we again call the function for the 2. It is divided by again 2 plus fact of 3. Again, we call the function factorial for calculating the factorial of 3. Again, whatever the answer is there, that is divided by the 3 plus factorial of 4. We call the function. Again, it is divided by the 4. Plus again we call the function for calculating the factorial of 5. Again it is divided by the 5 and it is end with the semicolon. After that we display the message on the screen, printf the series, our series is 1 factorial divided by 1 plus 2 factorial divided by 2 plus 3 factorial divided by 3 plus 4 factorial divided by 4 plus 5 factorial divided by 5. So we first of all showing the message on the screen and end with the semicolon, and after that we display the message on the screen, printf the sum of series is, we use the format specifier %d because sum is of type integer and we end with the semicolon. Okay, this is our main function. After this, we write down our function definition for the calculating the factorial. Here we write down the return type integer, name of the function is factor, fact. Here it takes one parameter of type integer. Okay, the name of the variable is n. Okay, here we write down the function body. Here we take the one variable num, and we initially send the value 0 to the num, and for storing the factorial we use the f variable and it is initialized to the one value. Here we use the while loop. Here in the while loop we specify the condition, the given number num is less than or equal to n minus 1, the loop will be iterating. After that, here we calculate the factorial and we add it. So here we added the number, so whatever the number is there, that is stored in the f value. So we are put f equal to f plus f into num, value of the num, and end with the semicolon. And after that we increment the num value by 1 every time. This we return the value that is storing in the f. So here we use return function, return, for returning the value that is stored in the f, and that value is returned to the function, that value is returned to the main function, and that value is stored in the sum. So first of all we see the execution of this loop or this function. So here initial the value of n is 1, so 1, and here the num is initialized to 0. So 0 is less than equal to, here our value is n is nothing but 1. So 1 minus 1 means 0 is less than equal to 0. Condition becomes true, the control go inside the while loop. So here we initialize the f to the 1. So 1 plus 1 into num. So 1 into num, the value stored in the num variable is 0. So after multiplication the value becomes 0. 0 plus 1, the value stored in the f is 1. After that we increment the num value, num becomes 1. So here 1 is less than equal to 0, condition becomes false, control come out of the loop and it returns the value of f to the calling function. So it returns the value 1 to the this function. So here 1 divided by 1, it becomes 1. Similarly, here we call the function fact of 2. Again function is called, so here n value is 2. Then initially num is 0, 0 is less than or equal to 2 minus 1 means 1, f equal to f plus f into num. So here f is 1, 1 plus 1 into our num value is 0. So again f into num becomes 0, 0 plus 1, f becomes 1, again num plus plus, the num becomes 1. 1 is less than or equal to 1, yes, here the equality condition is true. Then again control come in the loop. So here the f value is 1, 1 plus 1 into num. So here num value is 1. So 1 into 1 plus 1, 1 into 1, 1 plus 1, answer is 2. The value stored in the f is 2. Again num plus plus, num value becomes 2. The given condition becomes false. Come control come out of the loop. Here the return function returning the value 2 to this function, to f. Fact of 2 is nothing but 2, 2 divided by 2, it returns the value 1. Similarly, we call for the fact of 3. So when the function is called fact of 3, the control is come here. Similarly, we call for the fact of 3. So fact of 3, here the n value becomes 3. So initially, the num value is 0. 0 is less than equal to, loop is continued till 2. F value is stored in the 2, 2 plus 2 into 0, so 2 plus 2, 2 into 0 means 0, the value stored in the f is 2, then num plus plus, so here num becomes 1, so 2 plus 2 into 1, so again 2 plus 2 means 4, the value of f becomes 4, again num becomes 2, to 2 plus 2 into 2, to 2 into 2 4, 4 plus 2 6, so here f value becomes 6, num plus plus, num becomes 3, control condition becomes false, control come out of the loop, f value is returned, 3 factorial is 6, and then we 3 6 6 divided by 3, it returns the value 2. Similarly, we call for the factor of 4 and factor of 5. After that, we compile this file. It shows 0 error, 0 warnings. Then we run the program. The sum of the series is 34. Now, after seeing this concept, can you implement the code for displaying the sum of the following series? Pause the video and think about it. Here in this series, we calculate the sum of 1 divided by 1 factorial plus 4 divided by 2 factorial plus 27 divided by 3 factorial. This program, we write the code. Here we calculate the factorial. So here we specify the fact function. It takes the one parameter of type integer. Here we calculate, here we declare one variable f and it is assigned the value 1. And here we use the I is initialized to n, I is greater than equal to 1, I minus minus. Here we calculate the factorial. So here we specify f equal to f into I. After that we return the f to the calling function f fact. Now these are the references. Thank you.